See, what the...
Again? There we go.
Ahoy, everyone, and welcome aboard. I'll be your Captain Hillyan today, along with...
First Mate Rakir, at your service, and I recognize this game.
Welcome to Showcase Sunday, where typically we would show around four games, possibly a few more, to see if they're any good for streaming or not. And with this one, I can say it will be a not, because this is basically... I think you can get the main gist of this game just from this picture. It's a city builder, but you're stacking everything on top of each other.
Yeah, I have seen you two play this.
Okay.
And yeah, I only did one episode, really.
Yeah. So we're going to run a mission or two through this. Typically we'd go for about half an hour, but yeah, there's not much to find here. At least for us. So yeah, let's just go through the tutorial. Welcome to Balance City, I'm Sub. Your Secretary of Urban Planning. I've come to show you how all this works. This is your first time as a mayor, follow my lead. Hello, thank you for the follow, GlacierBoy7Y7.
Glacier, hello again! Oh yeah, I know them.
Okay, welcome to the stream and I hope you'll enjoy it. We won't be sticking around with this game specifically as fast. Let's see. If this is your first lead as a mayor, follow my lead. Our city must be in perfect balance, quite literally. If you build too much on one side, everything will surely collapse. Focus on creating a symmetrical design from the middle to the sides. Use the buttons on the top bar to create buildings. You can choose from any of the available buttons, which are, at the moment, are zero. From now, I will activate the most important button of all. You are authorized to build your new home. Can't create your house using the start building button. Might as well slap it right in the middle. Every time you build a star building, your height limit will rise. This is over here. Now you can build up to 100 meters high. When you reach a population of 250, you will be able to build another star building. At 500, 750, 1000, and so on, you will be able to build another star building. And the height limit will also increase. The key is having the most inheritance in order to build... the tallest city in the world. So basically, yeah, they want us to build basically those mega city spires from RoboCop or whatever it was, from Cyberpunk games, only a lot more chaotic.
Let's build apartments, dear.
Residential button, and build four blocks. 1, 2, 3. 4.
Yeah, I think I see what you mean, chaotic. You didn't even properly place the other cube on top of the other at all.
Yeah. Look at those beautiful homes. Now why won't anybody want to live there? There's something missing. You know, energy. Can you see that their lights are off? Advice that you build a power plant ASAP. Power plants are big and heavy. Try not to unbalance the city. Touch the power plant button, build one in the middle of the platform. So, right on top of the rest.
What the heck?
Our homes have energy, but there is still nobody living there. At Urban Planning School, they told me that residents need energy and jobs. Our citizens need offices for them to work in. Touch the offices building button and build a couple for them next to the apartments. So, one there, one there.
Yeah, you can see easily why we will not make a series of this.
Yeah. This is basically one of those games that is a challenge, to challenge yourself. When not much else, really. Okay. Offices also need energy. Each power plant can supply energy for 15 office and residential blocks. Watch how your population starts to grow. Nice and beautiful urban development. I'm not sure if it is that pleasant to live next to a power plant. Some studies show that smoke is bad for our health. I think plenty showed them. Living that a couple of trees won't cure. Plant some trees next to our residences. Okay. I guess you could use these to make small corrections in balance, though I don't think it's actually affecting... I don't think it actually is moving at the moment. Okay, build a terrace and plant some trees over it. There you go.
What? Did that tree just...
fall, yes. With clean air, your population will grow. Oh, remember that citizens love to have trees nearby. The city also deserves an efficient transport system. You can build a train station near the floor. Build a train station. Watch out not to unbalance the city. I don't think it is actually. Yeah, it's not. It's not being affected.
No, but I thought it was to just fly off the edge.
Means of transport increase the number of citizens. You can build train stations and airports. The airport will be available when your city reaches over 200 meters. Just be careful not to cause an accident. That's all I can tell you now. You're ready to face the challenge. The city trusts you. They shouldn't. Don't be scared, I'll be around to help. If something big seems wrong, I'll let you know now. Before there is a tragedy, now let us build a city that reaches to the heavens. So that we make a main... No. That we may make a name for ourselves. Good luck, Mayor. Okay, and just leave us on.
He was to build a city on top of this.
Plate spinner who likes the Tale of Babylon, or the Tower of Babylon.
Dear.
But yeah, that is where we're going to leave this one. I didn't even start a bloody timer on it. And it only took 7 minutes. But yeah, we said we would be a lot less picky with... Okay, the second one had an update, it seems. So just have to put that in quickly. We did say we were going to be a lot less picky with we bring up on... what we showcase on the second round go, at the second pass of this. Okay,
Hello. Oh dear.
I've still left out some games here and there, but mostly MMOs that we don't really have the time to stream with.
Yeah, that's a very good idea. And I think that's the first time we had to wait for a game to update.
I did start it up earlier, so it isn't that it has a startup thing going like some games have at times. Okay, it is only 30 seconds left, it says. Of course, it says, so it could be another minute or so, but it seems to be progressing fast enough. And I just realized that a car outside is reflecting sunlight into my room, directly into where my head is. So, let me see.
I can sort of relate, though not with cars, more of neighbor's solar panels.
Okay. I can't close the blinds any further, so I'll just have to lean back a bit until they get lost. Okay, play game. Pardon. Okay, should be catching on any second.
All right, let's see.
There we go.
Hopefully this is a bit more exciting. What the...
Anyone who has ever seen anything of that Poland Ball comic on the Reddit or elsewhere, I don't know where else to find it really, this will look very familiar.
You know what, is it the same people behind it, or just they are inspired by them?
I'm not entirely sure. It's not really a... Anyone can make those Poland Balls comics, but I don't really know if there is any specifics about it. Now let's see. Yeah, this is Bang on Balls Chronicles, and from what little I've seen of this game, it does interest me quite a bit in the humor and such. Okay.
Oh dear, I'm already concerned.
Let's start up the timer. Spacebar to jump. Oh, we have a double jump. Okay. Extra height and distance. Yeah, we have a charge. Jump, jump,
you,
charge.
You were to break the fourth wall sooner or later.
Okay. We can charge by just rolling on through. Knock things over. And the ground pound, which actually... Okay, that's a first. That's something that actually just damages the... Or the first that like I've seen. That the button actually gets damaged. Trampolines.
Yeah, usually when you see that happen, usually in a cutscene or something. Just not part of the game, though.
Okay, shift. Okay, that sucks in things. And you are a save station. Okay. And yeah, there is a sort of combat in this game. As well, at the moment we can bully a crash dash ball, a crash test ball.
Oh, bastard! Wait, what? He has a shield.
We can bounce off of enemies. I'm guessing these orbs are going to be used for something. That's health. Health and size. Okay. And bigger size is more damage, but more slow, moving more slowly, I presume. Okay. And what is with the rock? Okay. X to show where you need to go, I presume. Okay. Blew that one up like a freaking Luma.
It stole the shield!
Okay, with our own shield, we can block, stun them, and then get to them whilst they're stunned.
Please tell me, is the game doing the slurping sound?
Yep.
What the heck?
Let's see. Okay, so we have an inventory. All right. And, well, mostly for the looks, it seems. Okay, another photo. Really?
You did roll up quite close to it.
Okay. You are invulnerable, so we can use you to get over here. Okay, locks just take a bit more to break.
Oh dear.
A rather simplistic tutorial, but it does get the point across. Okay, so we have these two that are going to hold down the pressure plates, and then we can move on. And that's the tutorial.
And there we go.
All right, then use fill rooms to open doors. Okay, so fill rooms are like the stars or jiggies in this game. And really, one of you is a soccer ball. That is just straight up a soccer ball.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, and what's behind here? Oh, it's this. It's the Scandinavian set and the Roman set. What? Let's just take a look whatever's going on here. Okay, destroy Viking boats, save the villagers, collect film wheels to unlock future levels.
Uh-oh. Wait, really it look different for each level?
I saw that there is some, customization. So I presume you can change things up for yourself, but sometimes you might be forced into some looks, I guess. And we got a leather cap from that one. What is with these glowing mushrooms? Okay, they're actually working on something.
Are you gonna betray him? Really?
Let's see. Sheep balls, really?
The heck?
It looks like this game could be fun, but it doesn't seem to have much of an active story going on except for, well, the background for each of the levels themselves.
Yeah, as far I have heard people call their pets a lot like a little fluff ball, but this is ridiculous.
Okay, I see glowies in the trees. Yeah, those are health. And it seems that if we reach certain thresholds, we might go up in size with those. Let's see. Okay, we need someone to help with this, or we need to chase one of the sheep onto it.
For him? And it's a Dane.
It's the easiest way to deal with you is to try and get behind you. Though you are very quick on the turn. Oh, or we just ground pound on his head for a while.
I did say on top. But here comes the Swedes! Kinsmen!
And I think the Dane just knocked one of them away. They turn into skulls. Okay.
They do have skulls? Alright.
Come on. Here we go. And that's that. Okay, a prior. I hear snoring.
Yeah. I was just gonna say, that's not me snoring.
Yeah, the game isn't that boring. Oh. Oh, and now it's our time to be big.
Uh-oh.
And there goes that. I guess it's only temporary then. Come on. This is something funny about just going around that big ass shield.
Dear.
But yeah, a little light on the active story, but it still looks like this game could be fun just to play around with.
Yeah, I can see this work as a backup game.
Just tossed him into the freaking chandelier. Let's see. There's Viking ships over there. Boink. Get into the chandeliers. It sounds like there's a... Ah, there they are. There we go. Boink. And I think they killed the one that had something on offer.
Dear.
Boink. Where are all... Are you spawning them? Yes, you are literally just throwing them.
Norway. Norway is throwing Swedish bot. I mean, not finish that sentence. But yeah, I feel like that could be taken out of so many contexts.
Okay. Come on. I'm trying to get above him so I can ground pound him. Oop. Did not mean to break through there, but oh well.
Yeah, you ground pounded the wrong thing.
Bye bye. Actually scared him. Okay, here we go. Uno, dos, tres, cuatro.
And you failed. I think. Oh dear.
What the?
Did you?
Oh, I got underneath that. It's...
I thought, well, you already somehow broke the game.
not yet. Okay. One more time should do it.
Not to break the game.
And yes, I did see that over there. We'll try and grab it in a bit. But yeah, it seems like this game looks very much like a Super Land, but a lot more open world. It will probably have to collect abilities. Oop. Let's see, all items, shield, cap. Bye bye. Okay, we got a book, but was that an... Let's see. Main menu items, Viking items. There. Wait, we can use the book as a shield? Okay.
What?
I guess you could say that our faith protects us. Or something along that line.
You have become a monk!
All right. Boink. Oh, hello.
I have a feeling you don't want to bump his head.
Yeah. And again, everything about them is head.
Yeah, you know what I mean. He had a... I can't believe it. This is probably the few games where a horned helmet will be helpful.
Yep.
Otherwise, horned helmets are selling up people useless.
Okay, another cap. Now we look like a monk.
Oh dear, Friar Hillyan.
Okay, there was something around here that cost 1500. We are a bit short on that.
Chest? Behind you? What the heck is...
Okay, so it's not just a shield.
What do you do?
Okay, let's just collect these for a bit. See if we can get supersized.
Was some chest on these pillars near you?
Yep.
That one there. It was a cross.
Okay, we can get to that from up there, I'm guessing, if we can get there. And we have bunny balls.
Oh no. Come on! Don't kick the bunnies!
Go. And we, I think that should be, enough. Also, how can we get you down from here? Oh, hello. This is always nice.
Okay, that is nice.
Great. Really?
It's not an item.
No, it is an item up there, but, The monk is up to shenanigans.
Dear.
Okay, let's get some speeds. Jump, jump, charge, and get.
But what did you get then, how?
Wait, you were a skunk? But no, you were wearing a skunk mask. And what we got was this cap.
Are you sure that's not a badger?
Yeah, badger could also be. What do you have for sale here? Okay, so... hello, Badgerzilla.
Yeah, that's a badger.
Oh, and it's hostile. Angry.
Oh, great. Well, it could have been worse. It could have been a bunny badger or a damn wolverine. And yes, those are related. Same family and all.
Here we go. Come on, supercharge. And there we go. 15 health each time. Give me that.
Okay, it seems Glacier Boy also found it pissing funny.
Okay, now that that's been unlocked, what the hell is actually in here? A badger hat. Oh, and... wait, are you sticking along? Yes. Okay, we got a little badger buddy.
Oh dear. The badger monk. Oh, badger priest? And the sheep's on next.
Well, it looks to me like... This game is just mostly for the fun of it, exploring, gathering stuff, and just having fun with it.
Yeah, not much of a story, so we probably don't stream it too much, if at all.
At least a better case of a showcase Sunday, that something we wouldn't put on stream, but it's still fun to... hello. It's still fun to, give a shot. And maybe play some other time.
Yeah.
Or if other people want to play it.
Yeah, we could definitely recommend it. Like, if you are into these kind of games, then this is probably your game.
Give me that.
The heck?
It sounded like someone strangled the hornblower whilst they were playing.
It's a description.
And what is this? Oop. Okay. Can we get even higher? Oh, there's an entire whirlwind that's kicked up. Okay.
Wait. Look at the ground, Hillyan.
Yeah. Oh, more crystals. Okay.
Is it magic ice crystals?
Looks like it, and we ticked off the goat.
Oh dear. Yeah, it's furious.
Oh, we gotta fight goats with, well, goat tactics. You are very aggressive. There we go. Let's heal up because we need it.
Wait, why is it pink?
Oh yeah, we're definitely doing something with all of this. Okay, that's two. There's a third over there. I saw something that could be interacted with. Okay, lad. No. As fun and hilarious as that, the shenanigans that could be from that. Let's not. Let's see. Someone didn't like the horns music. So basically, Cacophonics from Asterix was playing. And again, he plays a lyre. Or a harp.
I think it's a harp.
There we go.
I mean, I'm sure suddenly.
Oh, hello. Okay, snowman all of a sudden.
But you were breaking ice crystals of some kind.
I should totally have expected that.
Wait, what? Why did that snowman turn into a skull?
No clue. Now, did that change anything up here?
I'm suddenly concerned.
This is a big. Oh, hello. Okay, I see. There's something new up there. We can use the wind. From that spawned from the crystals to get to it. Oop. Come on, stay in the flow. Okay. One air draft, second, and there. Okay. Hello. Rather cold welcome.
Yeah, I think he gave you the cold shoulder.
Oh, but now we have an ice wand as a weapon. Okay.
Have you sort of become the Badger Wizard?
I guess so. And the prior is still trying to extinguish an imaginary fire. Okay, so it looks like equipable items that actually have an effect have a cooldown before they can be used again. But yeah, an ice wand obviously freezes stuff.
Rock balls!
Okay, for now though, let's go... Let's see if we can get to one of those Viking ships and wreck them before we run out of time with this. Maybe that will cause maybe that will cause a bit of story to pop up. There's 9 of them in total, okay. Come on. Is that enough to count? Doesn't look like it. Or is it more 9 clusters of them or something. Yep. Wait, what are you?
Yeah, I think you were too... Yeah, you're broken too so far. Wait, what?
I thought these were boulders, but they're freaking seals.
I mistook those for rocks.
So did I. Okay. Let's go grab a save here. And another of those horns. Where are those moles? Okay, the horns are separate collectibles as well. Okay, this looks like it could be fun, but not much of a story game. So...
Oh dear.
I'll slap it down as a maybe for when we want to do something else or an in-between something. Or just have some fun on the stream.
I just gonna throw some food into the machine while you prepare the next game.
Yeah, which is the Banner Saga. Which, well, among fans of this kind of game, it got quite famous. Though I never got too far into it, really. So, let's set up a new game. The story in Banner Saga changes based on the choices we make. You will occasionally switch between lead characters, witnessing the story unfold from different perspectives. Let's start the timer there. The gods are dead. In their wake, man and giant survives through a tenuous alliance driving black destroyers called Dredge deep into the northern waste. Now is an era of growth and trade. Life goes on. Only one thing has stopped. The sun. That can't be good. Welcome back.
It has been several long months on the road. The first signs of snowfall accost us on our approach to Strand, largest of the trade cities on the Val-human borders, and our last collection before returning to the capital. Several days ago, the sun simply came to a stop in the sky. Though during these long winter days, none of us can be certain how long it has been this way. Some of the men in the caravan have taken it as a dire omen. I am not quick to superstition, but I myself will be glad to be done with this year's rounds. We have been warned by stranded travelers about brigands on the path through Richhorn, our road home. Our captain seems unconcerned. Perhaps he is as eager as I to be done here. We will rest here this day and inquire further when we speak to the governor.
And yeah, from one game with Vikings to another, huh?
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
These are some very good animations.
Let's see, you can probably tell if that is actual Scandinavian language or not. I can't
very
really tell.
Old. Very old, I think.
Okay.
So I will be struggling to translate it even.
Let's see. You've arrived just in time. The chieftain in red and his men are now looking at a tougher fight than they bargained for. Drag around the screen to see your surroundings. click the check mark to continue. These portraits show the order of initiative, taking turns from left to right. Your allies are blue, the enemy is red. It's your time to act. Something is in my eye. Give me a second.
Where is an eye patch?
There we go. That seems to have gotten rid of it. Movement happens before action. The ring shows your shield banger is active. The shield sent to them. The blue tiles around him show where he can move. Some characters feel more tiles than others. The horned allies are a race of giants called Varl, who will take up four tiles each, while humans fill a single tile. This can have a huge impact on your strategy. Click the tile you want to move to, then click the check mark to confirm. Move your shield banger here and get him into attack range. Okay. Target an enemy, click the tile in which they stand. Allied tiles are blue, enemies are red. Target this enemy, black. Okay. So the ring shows where they can move, not where they can attack still. Okay. You can either choose to attack the enemy's strength or break his armor. The number beneath each icon, 2, 5, shows the damage you will do to that stat. So if we go for his armor, it would just damage it. If we go for his strength, it will outright kill him. Yep, strength counts as both health and damage. A loss of 2 strength means you'll do 2 less damage. If strength falls to 0, the character falls in battle. Okay. Armor blocks strength damage, but can be reduced by a break attack. By breaking armor, you open them up to take more damage in the future. Okay. So it's a balance of, do you go for armor to get a stronger hit in, or do you hit them so they can hit you less? This enemy has only 5 strength remaining. A strength attack will kill him. The fist, then confirm. He's down. Each time you make a kill, your renown grows, which is used later to improve your characters. After taking the action, your turn ends. Next up is the enemy. Turns always alternate, even if you are outnumbered. Okay. Despite being at full strength, the chieftain can do little damage against your shield banger's high armor. Now is your warhawk's turn. He appears to be out of range of those enemies, but all characters can use willpower to boost their actions. Willpower is a limited resource, so use it wisely. By clicking on gold tiles, a character can move further than usual at the cost of 1 willpower per gold tile. Red pulsing tiles beneath your enemy show how close you have to get in range. Move your warhawk in attack range. There we go. That will cost 2 will of 8. Yep. Standard attacks only affect a single enemy, but your warhawk has a special ability that gives him a unique advantage. Click on your warhawk's tile to access his ability. Clicking your character's tile will bring up all his combat options, including move, ability, attack, and end turn. Ability. Tempest. This ability, the ability description appears in tooltips below. The Warhawk's Tempest allows him to slam multiple enemies at once. Select an enemy and confirm your choice. Okay, very useful. But potentially also very much a glass cannon. That make quick work of the chief. That make quick work of the chieftain's bodyguards. When there is only 1 enemy left, players enter pillage mode. During pillage, each character moves in order and there are no more guaranteed turns. Check the initiative to see the order, how the order has changed. Your allies will now get to move twice in a row. Okay, so that this is meant so you can chase characters down instead of having to, well, everyone taking a turn each time and just going around in circles. Also, yeah. Is it a freaking polar bear?
Yeah, I think that's a polar bear. And also, that's a good mechanic.
If a character does not move on his turn, he will rest to gain 1 willpower. The chieftain will rest this turn. Okay, looks like the chieftain is in some trouble. Your shieldbringer won't be able to finish the job with a normal attack, but willpower can be used to boost your damage. Click the chieftain's tile to attack. Yep, we're 1 short. Click on the fist, then the stars above the fist to add willpower. The number of stars available each turn are determined by your exertion stat. You'll see the damage number go up as you add willpower. Click a star and then the left then the green check mark will to kill this enemy. Okay, one will added and done. That's that. Oof. And 6 renown gains.
Nice.
Like a rabid wolf, that one. How did it come to this? We fool ourselves believing that peace will last. My grandfather built all this from a poor fishing village, you know. He watched the gods die, watched the chaos that followed, watched man and var slaughter each other, even before the dreads arose. All we've done is traded one struggle for another. Now that there are no more dreads to war against, we war against ourselves. This chieftain meant to kill me, and he's not the first. A dozen families in the city would gladly take my chair. This one had men waylaying merchants, both north and south of the city, strangling trade quite well, I would add, though he denied it to his lust. This sort of wolf doesn't stop biting because the head is cut off. It just grows a new head. I am in a bad way, my friend. Help me finish this fight, and I'll gladly send you on your way with double our king's tithe. Take any men you need. They're loyal. I promise you that. They will meet you down in the proving grounds.
And so far, they've all haven't even said a single word, I think.
Yeah, but again, this game looks good. I can see why it has so many fans.
And it has 2 sequels now, but I've never gotten far in this game because it is pretty damn tough as well. Let's see.
Oh dear.
You're approached by a familiar man who walks in step with you as you're leaving the Great Hall. He cuts to the chase. Eric, steward of Strand. I manage the governor's business. Uben, isn't it? Let's see. It is. The governor tells me you'll be giving us a hand. Seems a bit chaotic around here, Eric. It's been worse. We've got a lot of irons in the fire. What does he want exactly? Skelfings that you didn't hack up in the Great Hall scattered after you took out their chieftain. The governor just wants to make sure they stay down. Was hoping you'd join me in the marketplace by the docks. If there's anyone left to worry about, I know who can tell us. Okay. Make the market tent to visit the merchant, okay. Let me handle this. You meander through rows of open-faced houses and eroded stalls. Colored canvases flap on a briny current. One man in particular blanches as you approach. Dad, I'm not in the mood today. For what? Talking to an idiot. The Skelfing's chieftain bled out about an hour ago, Dad. So when you tell me that what rate that anus the rest of them crawled in back into, nobody's going to try to kill you this time. They don't talk to me. Iric needs some help here. Had I had a change of heart, I hope you do give us a hard time. Had sweats visibly, fumbling with some dirty trinkets on his table. Wait, just buy one of these. If everyone thinks I'm getting worked over every week, how am I supposed to know much? Just a little food money, yeah? Might as well. You toss a sliver of silver on the table. Both men look at you with surprise. Had gestures meekly to a variety of junk from his stall. Take whatever you like. The only thing I'd like is the name of a place. Nobleman, up by the east wall. But that was months ago, last I know. Had skulks away with a wave of Ivic's hand, gathering things from his hovel. Disappearing for a while until this blows over, you figure. Your bodyguard steps forward. Gunnulf, are we done here? Gunnulf, were you wearing green back at the Great Hall? No, just bought them while you were walking around. Why? You look like a frog. Better than an eggplant.
The heck?
Gunnulf goes off to look at more stalls. Eric, that man's of yours seems unreliable at best. A blind dog wouldn't trust Had, but he used to be scalping. If they're licking their wounds, they've probably gone to old haunts, not new ones. Nobleman is a meat hall. Best I can tell, the name's ironic. Listen, I know a guy who would love to put a few of these skulls in the ground. I'm going to find him. I'll meet you there. Shouldn't we have an approach of some sort? What a luxury. Come on, you've already mopped up worse today. Just make sure the governor remembers his promise. Double the usual tithe. I'll remind him. And here's the meat house. You arrive in front of what must be noblemen. A few minutes later, Eirik appears with a weather-beaten man introduced as Valgard. I'll point him out, Eirik says over his shoulder. Ready? Yeah, you're walking through the front door. They ran to a mead house, says Valgard. I'll be surprised if they can stand up straight right now. Okay, here we go. He does have a point. Valgard boots the front door open so hard it won't close again without repair. As you enter the hall, Eirik is already at the head of a table, his axe drawn. Wide-eyed, drunken scalflings scramble to find their own weapons, turning tables and meat steins in the process. And more combat.
Oh dear.
Okay. Seems we can... Oh yeah, I remember this. You can select where your characters will be standing and such, and... He's just standing at the back there. Thanks, dude. There we go. Clicked the wrong thing there. Look at them, it's going to be butchery. Can we see how far they can move? Yes, we can. Shield wall, plus one armor to adjacent allies and self. Okay. Let's move over here, just outside of their range. That means they'll have to use up their willpower, because it seems they have access to that as well. Yes, they have four. Let's see. Oh, okay, you can't swap. Yeah. You can't swap between allies. You just have to go with whoever you have. Okay, you... Is there such a thing as flanking in this game? It doesn't look like it, at least.
What the... I think someone been crushed over under a table up there. What the heck happened?
That's more like a bench. This one's just enjoying the show. He probably just got knocked out in the first strike or something. Okay. These guys don't have too much... These guys don't have too much defense. Let's see. You can do your Tempest. There we go. Oh, but that actually strikes twice. Okay. Or did it?
Well, it hit both of them.
Okay, move here. And then strike. These guys have low health or low strength. So just... Oops. Okay, that's a flurry of attacks. So yeah, it's easier to take them out than to weaken their armor.
I'm impressed by the details in the clothing. Like, it is simple clothing, all that, and simple weapons and armor, but they still done details they could have skipped, like... Like the extra planks on the round shields and the long shield there, which would have been there. Other games usually just ignore those little bits.
Okay, this guy needs to help. It needs help. Actually, we're going to need to break that one's armor and this one's.
Oh dear.
Hmm. What would be smarter here?
Check on my food, so don't die.
It might just be smarter to get the hell out of there, because there is permadeath in this game, that I know for a certain. Oh, that's their shield wall ability. Okay, spend one willpower to get in range here. And might as well finish him off. Okay. Oh, it seems that it also shows how much damage you will do on a target if you can get to them. Yeah, deal 6 damage, just get to that. Okay, that is useful to know, that otherwise you'd have to, well, waste a turn to get to a target. You can deal 2 damage to that one or 1 to that one. Let's spend another will to get behind him and half the amount of damage he can do. Oh, that was another special, it looked like. Okay, this one's turn is next, so let's just end him. And pillage. And done. Yeah, this shows that combat can get quite tricky. Let's see, promotion, Iric. I've forgotten what that means. Probably a level up. There they are. Gods be damned. I've got to wash off this blood. Eric is looking out of the hall's window, windows onto the bay. A fleet of longship approached with sails both red and blue. One banner I know well, Wagner. Next for Val King's ship last we spoke. The other flag looks important. Yeah, important guests. See what I deal with all day long? Things make a little more sense. You'd hoped I'd have a stake in saying everything's fine here when the royal guests arrived. Not me, the governor. Now we have to make sure there is no running, there are no running bodies or bulls of Endril still in the Great Hall before they come by. Can I ask one more favor? What is it? If you happen to stall our guests down on the docks, I wouldn't object. Maybe I will. Iric and Volgard hustle from the meat house. To his credit, Iric tosses the barkeep a spar of silver for the mess. You give an apologetic shrug and go to meet the new arrivals down at the docks.
Dear, that's something to return to.
Yeah, quite a amount of visitors.
Holy.
Wagner? A familiar Vol steps onto the docks. In your mind, you recall a much younger version tramping the halls of Grofheim, abundant in purpose. God, Zubin, you're looking ancient. Comes with being old, and if there is Wagner, there must be Hakon. Your Hakon? Must be? Is dubleting tributes from the poor and stupid, all the ox? At what age do you lose a sense of shame? Gerander demands it. I'll take that over lingering to death in Grofheim. Speaking of, I had no sense that you were so far from home. Just returned from Arborang. In fact, I'm glad for it. Hakon motions to the other ships in the bay, sails still fluttering. Golden wolf head emblazoned on red, the king of men, or someone on his behalf. The king's whelp. The king's son, Ludin. Don't you know, Scrivener? We visit his capital, he visits ours. It is how you make alliances these days. It's a miserable waste of time. Yes, Hakon has it. I'd almost forgotten. It's a good thing you're around, Hakon. Then you're going to Grofheim? I have a distinct feeling I finished my business in Strand and was heading there myself. We should caravan. We should. Give it a day. In better circumstances, I'd drink a week away, but let's just be done. Find me tomorrow at the gates. What he's trying to say is the prince is the light to behold. Where's Moger? Hakon, have him find a place to put the warriors. I'll be heading up to meet the governor. A host of giants depart in his wake. You recognize a few, others are strangers to you. Guess I'm off to find Moger. I'll see you in the morning, Shrivener. Whatever the hell that means. I'll be along. The young prince of men ambles from his ship. He brushes off his tunic, scanning the beach with low eyelids. Ludin looks for all the world the sort of boy who grew up pulling the legs from spiders. The long road back to Grafheim should be more interesting than most years, you think.
You don't know where the Scrivener is?
No, actually. Or maybe it sounds like a some sort of scribe version or something, or an old word for that.
I'll give you a hint. He's holding a pen.
Yeah, so basically, a scribe of sorts. Though yeah, in this case, probably one related to taxes.
Or more of the one dealing with paperwork in the caravan.
Okay. Weariness suddenly settles in, and you chuckle to yourself about what an odd day it has been. One of the governor's men at the Great Hall could find you a place to sleep. On the other hand, if you're going to join Wagner's caravan tomorrow, it might not hurt to share a drink with Hakon or introduce yourself to the prince they spoke so highly of. Okay, click a talk icon to converse with one of your heroes. Okay, because we'll go after Hakon. And that's the timer. So we'll just finish the chatter up here and then we'll end it. Scrivener, you find Hakon in a mead house surrounded by other Vol. Trent is no stranger to Vol, but rarely see this many. Hakon waves you over. Went straight for a flagon? Wagner's the one who agreed to pass up a drink. I wasn't invited to the governor's hall anyway. You already missed the massacre. Every year I come and make the rounds to collect taxes. Every year it's the human settlements that give me trouble. No surprise, what this time? When I got here, the Great Hall was already full of bodies. We added a few more. Humans. I guess if I only lived as long as a Yogg-Svart, I might be desperate to make something of myself, too. It's not too late to start trying, Hakon. Hakon lets slip a low chuckle. Any of all could recount his deeds, known as he is for cutting a swath through Dredge at Wagner's side in the Second War, and regularly since then. Down here, I'm a glorified bodyguard. You might have a point. Just another reason to get back to Grafheim. Soon enough, I imagine. You drink until the mead house becomes overbearing, then step back into the cool air outside. There is one part of the gameplay that we haven't gotten to touch, and that is the actual traveling between points, during which events will pop up. I don't know if they're random or predetermined, but it will affect things like, well, your caravan's morale, how many people you have with you, the supplies that you have. And let's see, full screen is not needed. Difficulty, I would definitely, if we were to stream this, I would definitely put this on easy, because yeah, you can suffer some severe damage even between combat encounters through the travels, because some people can die along the way.
Yeah, that's probably a good idea.
I might even just pull out, yeah, I might even pull out a spoilerless guide to avoid just complete pitfalls. For now, we'll have to call it there on the Banner Saga.
If we were to stream this, we also will investigate how long it will take to beat it.
Yeah, these RPGs can last a hell of a time. Though I guess the full story might actually be split off across all three of the games to make it it is a trilogy. Might as well. I'm not too sure if. Again, I didn't get too far into it, so I can't actually even. I don't know if the first game is only like the first of a trilogy of the complete story or not. Okay, we'll have to investigate that as well. For now, we're moving on to the next game. Which, well, is similar to Bang on Balls Chronicles in that it is mostly meant for the fun of the gameplay. Also just... Someone is mystified by the cursor's existence. Okay. Let me delete that one. Yes. Oh, wait. I thought this was a difficulty selector, not just a different... Okay, there goes one save then. Let's go on normal modes and start anew. This music.
Dear. Oh, this dialogue.
Brad, our hero and local barbarian for hire, sleep soundly. However, evil cares not for his sleep patterns. Yet again, Brad is called upon to protect the town's prized decorative crystal. Any normal day, Brad would care. But today... Yeah, come on. He doesn't. Tired of grinding XP, saving useless NPCs, and living only to destroy... He uses some previously misplaced crafting skills and fashions a loot out of an old war axe. Armed with his new gear, he steps outside and shreds loot. Yeah, Bardbarian, a Bardbarian.
Oh dear.
Greetings, Meatbag. I'm Tutorial Goblin. I'm here to teach you the basics. Pay attention so you don't embarrass yourself. First step is taking your first steps. Walking may be may seem difficult, but I'm sure you can manage. You can move using the arrows, WSD, or controller, which I activated before this. I urge you to use a controller to get the finest barbaric experience. Okay, collect the chests. You're natural. Walking seems to be something you're capable of. Incredible. Shut up before I shove this thing down your throat. Notes are generated automatically as you play your axe loot. Standing still will cause you to jam and generate notes faster. Yeah, this game is basically a sort of... a sort of tower defense, only while you move around a lot more and you don't actually build towers. Use your notes to summon units to fight for you. You can have up to 3 units for now. Units are mapped to JKL keys. Use press J to summon an archer now. Trigger, press X on controller. Okay. And that calls someone out. Okay. We don't actively attack ourselves. So yeah, we need our allies to attack for us. This guy is tough. Let's use a power solo to give you a damage boost. You have 3 types of power solos: defense, speed, and attack. These solos can make or break your survival. Use them wisely to give yourself an edge in battle. Power solos are mapped to keyboards UIO. Click the button or press U to perform an attack solo and watch your archer destroy this goblin. Or in this case, X. And now he's doing a lot more damage. Of course, don't get hit by the rocks to get thrown. Nice, killing enemies fills this combo meter. After 5 kills, you can tap it to perform a stun solo. Don't get hit though, or your meter will be reset. The stun solo will knock back your enemies, stun them, and destroy all their projectiles. It may just save your life. Press space to try it now, A on controller. And like it said, it does an AoE stun, and there we go. There you have it, a primer in survival. Good timing too, because it looks like the goblins have arrived in full force. Use what you've learned to defend the town crystal and make it through the day. Good luck. Yeah, I think we might cut it short on this one as well. Because I believe that is the only bit of story that we're going to get. And beyond that, it's just a wave game to survive.
Okay.
And yeah, in the upper center of the screen, we can actually see where enemies are, so we can head forward towards them.
The heck was that? What was that? A dino statue?
Yes.
What the heck? Look at the wind in the window down there.
Yep, bigger goblin. Here we go, bigger loot. Of course, loot will vanish. Really, there's... The town is being invaded and you're just hanging out in the computer... in the computer cafe or whatever it would be called again, I forget.
It's in a computer cafe or their own house.
Okay, our allies, oh, that one dropped extra notes. Our allies have health bars of their own, so, but mostly our own counts. If Brad dies, then it's game over. You can just summon up more allies if needed. Oh, they got levels. And yeah, I think you can get the gist of the game so far. Nope, one of them got hit. It is a fun take on this sort of gameplay, though.
Oh yeah, because yeah, a bit pity if there's no other story.
Yeah, maybe if there was a sequel or such. Okay, one of ours is about to go down.
Like, it feels like there is a potential to do a fun story here. But, yeah.
One.
I can always hope that they do a sequel and they actually do a bit more a story.
Yeah, I think this game came out quite a while ago. I'll have to check when exactly.
Yeah, I think I've seen a little bit of the gameplay. I mean, when I saw this, it was in early access or something.
And yeah, beyond that, this game is basically a roguelike. Oh, this one has a shotgun effect. And, well, you're expected to fail at certain points, so you can actually, well, stop and spend your cash. Oh, hello, they heal up after, upon level up.
Oh, that's good.
Okay. Just gotta keep in mind that they follow wherever Brad walks, so they act basically like a trailer. And the music isn't bad, but it is a bit repetitive.
Yeah, though it's not too... Yeah, it's not bad. This one works all right to be repetitive.
One more.
Says it is. How to say? Almost generic rock. It's not good. It's not too bad either. Not too good. Just you can listen to it in the background without too much issue.
Yeah. Lo-fi beats to slaughter goblins too.
Yeah. And there's also an alternative to just turn off the music and turn your own music on as well.
Yep. Oop. What is the... Nope. I was going to say almost dead, but they are dead now. Okay, let's try a wizard. You can unlock different enemy types or ally types throughout the game. And yes, they do have to run over to you first. There we go. I don't know exactly what the wizard's attack does. It looks like it's a minor AoE or something. He does seem to have a lot more health. Oop. And yeah, new enemy type, a charger. They're actually marked up on the map as well. No, it seems we lost another one. Okay, power up. Nope. We don't want you at... Oh, and there goes the entire group. Okay, might as well pull up some fighters or a fighter because we're low on beats. These guys work like shotguns, I believe. Yep. And there goes the crystal. Okay. And with the gold that we got, we can, well, upgrade and unlock new characters. Let's see, Ghost Brand, what? A spooky medium-range ectoplasm ectoplasm machine gun, silent but deadly, really?
Oh no, I just saw two characters I recognize from other games. Octodad and Meat Boy.
Yep. Enjoys crying, hurting himself, and long runs on the beach. Strictly strict vegetarian, hint appears randomly in survival mode. Okay. And yeah, Octodad. Dishes big damage with little to no regard for his own well-being. Hint, last seen hanging around on wave 10. That means he's probably only becomes unlockable at that level.
Can I wonder, is it the same developer for both games or just crossover?
Yeah, crossover. I think, I'm not sure about Octodad, but I think Meat Boy and, well, Isaac. Actually, I'm not sure. I think some of these had a bit of a start on Newgrounds, and Newgrounds likes to cross over their stuff. This one, though, it appears the Kang clan has misplaced one of their war turtles. Hint, reached 2,000 meters in endless mode to unlock. Kang clan. I don't know what that is. I at first thought this was a reference to Jazz Jackrabbit. And yeah, these all have their own stats, health, attack, attack range. And there's a few more to unlock. We can also upgrade Brad himself. Or we can upgrade the party size. That is probably the most useful one. Body spray makes Brad's party smell better, causing them to get slightly closer together. And golden axe loot. 2x gold drops. And improved songs. And more health for you. But as we saw, it was the crystal that got owned the first. Which we can also upgrade. You double its health. The barracks. Physical followers spawn at higher levels. At max level, you get a defender on the rooftop. Okay. And same one for the magic followers. And pay some of the town shops to stay open and help you win the fight. Okay.
Okay.
And then there's the town pet. This little guy follows you around town picking up gold so you don't have to. At max level, he'll grab other things too. And the town drunk.
Really?
His bile slows enemies and can even weaken them when fully upgraded. But
what the heck?
Leg bang on balls would be fun to play every now and then, but not a full stream through. As I don't think we ever gave what we really do a name, but I think stream through might be fitting.
Maybe. We really had a backup game prepared or just done something else. We don't kind of rarely do that.
True. Anyways, next game. And we have over half an hour left. So if this one goes long enough, it'll be that. If not, we have backup games prepared. And this is Barony. It's basically what I've played this a bit. And it is an interesting game. Maybe not fully my thing, or maybe I just don't know the mechanics well enough yet. But this is basically a D&D game mixed together with a roguelike. Okay. Is there a randomized button? Yeah, random character. Let's see. Okay. Single player. You're not even going to show me what my character is going to be. Okay. Single player. Okay. There is some story here somewhere. Just need to find where it was put. Let's see.
I think I've seen this game before, or a game that looked similar to it, but had another name.
Here we go. Once upon a time in a faraway land, there stood a town called Hamlet. A hamlet called Hamlet. For generations, Hamlet served as a thriving center of commerce for all of the neighboring cities, and the luck of its people was second to none. It was until Baron Herx came to rule the land. The Baron, in his endless greed, forced his citizens to dig the surrounding hills for gold, though the earth had never yielded such treasure before. Meanwhile, as the people were forced to work, they schemed to undo their unjust leader. Eventually, they were able to trick him with a promise of gold and shield him within the mines themselves. However, in the years that passed since the people of Hamlet did away with their ruler, things did not go well for the people of the village. In a twist of fate, a variety of monsters began to erupt from the ground around the town. Some thought it was Herx exacting his revenge from beyond the grave, but none could be sure. Eventually, all trade in and out of the town stopped completely. Today, the region of Hamlet is considered cursed, and no one even knows if the town still exists. And yeah, that's the background. So, yeah, let's just load in on this again.
Logo edition? What? It said that the logo edition.
So, must be one of those joke things. I didn't notice it myself, but a few games do stuff like that, where they just change up the subtitle somewhat for the joke of it. Now, let's see. Here we go. Come on, let's get out of this. There we go. Basically, for people who know the Ultima series, or at least the Ultima Underworld games, this is basically that, but a roguelike version of it. We can attack with left mouse button, we can interact with right mouse. And from here on, we're on our own. You have to be careful in this game because death can come quickly. Let's see. Sword, let's shoot
them. You're bleeding, I think.
Okay. Yeah. You lose some blood. We don't actually have any healing items, it seems. Or, let's see. Brand new scroll of curse remove, slightly HGs. We can eat stuff to heal up, though. Okay, we got some gloves.
One health
from that.
One health from HGs, really?
Yep. Well, it is more realistic than completely healing up through chugging down five whole wheels. Yeah. We can pick up a torch.
At least you have stopped bleeding.
And yeah, everything is randomized.
All right, you are slowly regenerating. The word is slowly.
Let's see, what is this? Okay, you suddenly feel much. Oh, that's it. Yeah, fountains like that can have random effects. This one gave us a speed boost.
Nice.
They can, of course, be bad as well if you're unlucky. Might want to avoid going that way for a bit. Yeah, that's just the effect of randomization. Not everything is going to work. Hello.
You just found a broom closet.
Okay, we've got a lever and some gold. Yep, the praise ability has improved. There are skills. Not sure where to find them at the moment. We would go into the tutorial normally, but the tutorial of this is lengthy, to say the least.
Yeah. Didn't you speak to me about this game some time ago?
Yeah.
Actually, way before I joined the streams, I think just you and me talked about the finding games to play multiplayer on. And yeah, but was it a 3 hour long tutorial?
About. It could just have been, it doesn't hold your hand, to say the least, so you can actually fail in the tutorial and have to redo it.
Yeah, that just felt like a big no for me.
Yeah, there's a lot of mechanics underneath the surface here. I can hear something walking nearby.
Who is laughing?
Nope. Yeah, traps are one thing.
What the heck? That should be probably added to a funny moment.
Yeah, I've been thinking of going through my uploaded videos and hello, cracked amulet, and basically look for... Oh, that's cursed, it looks like. Glasses. Oop. And basically just try and make a compilation. Ooh, one health. Yeah. I did say desking from really, really quickly. Let's see. Pickaxe. And yeah, let's just take a look here. I forgot to start the timer. Oop. Another skeleton. And dead.
Play.
This game also has multiplayer, which would probably make it a lot easier. Okay.
Hey, can I harvest the Isengard? Okay, it's doing the Minecraft thing.
Yeah. Okay. Show race info. Friendly with humans and automatons. No weaknesses, no resistances, no traits. And we can't unlock... we don't have anything else unlocked. It seems... Okay, really all of them are locked behind DLC. Let me take a quick look. Okay, that's at least... $3 to $4 is more acceptable than... other games that have DLCs like that. Can we at least preview? No, we can't even preview. Okay, then we can select the class. It's the Barbarian, skilled combatant. What they lack in armor, they might make up for in strength and fighting prowess. Difficulty normal. Warrior, trained soldier. They are heavily armored and make capable leaders. Yep, leaders, because you can actually recruit NPCs in this to follow you around. Difficulty beginner.
Beginner. Yeah. I think you should have started with that one.
Then we have the healer. Well, speaks for itself. Normal, rogue, hard, wanderer, normal. Okay, low in armor and combat ability, but well equipped for the dungeon. Cleric. Students of the church, fairly well equipped and able in many ways. They are well-rounded adventurers. Let's hide that because it's not changing. Merchant, a seasoned trader, they are skilled in the market and adept at identifying foreign artifacts. Difficulty hard. Yeah. You don't automatically know what an item is. It takes time to appraise something, and well, the merchant is the best at that. Yeah. Wizard. Oh, Arcanist. With a gun. A cunning spellcaster. No, that's a crossbow. Less magically adept than the wizard, but hardier and better equipped. Normal difficulty. Joker, the wild card. Jokers come with very little equipment, but they have a few tricks up their sleeves nonetheless. What sleeves?
Oh dear.
Difficulty Wait. Extreme. Let's see. A temple officer who serves unseen, using stealth and magic to slip their way through the dungeon with the aid of a few rare tools. Difficulty hard. And we have the ninja.
I did not expect Sexton to be that. As well, that's Swedish for 16.
Okay. It's a highly specialized assassin. They ambush foes with swords or ranged weapons, using a few other tricks to get out of bad situations. Difficulty hard. And lastly, the monk. Disciplined and hardy, they have little in the way of offensive training and material goods, but can rely on their excellent fortitude and adaptability. Okay, let's go with the warrior.
Not everybody say a warrior starting with a spear, but kind of like that.
Let's go with that. And there. And this game probably would be quite fun if we had some other people to play this with, to, well, fill in some gaps. Okay. But yeah, I think this game would count as an immersive sim. Just pluck up the torch again. Okay. Everything with a hand on it is something that we have equipped. And yeah, as you can see, the environment changes every time. Okay, I don't know. I don't think.
I was just saying, I hope I expected to for Boulder to come again.
I think we set something off that did though.
Okay, now I'm. Okay, I hope I expect a boulder to come down the hall.
Well, it did somewhere. Bronze axe. Yeah, you'll want to collect weapons where you can. For one, they might be magic. And for two, your weapons have durability, so they will eventually break. A flawless ring. Amulets. Those should be getting identified over time.
You don't equip them on you like that, okay?
Yeah, we'd rather want to know if they're cursed or not first. How do we? Identification should start automatically, though I don't know if it shows. Up there it goes. Appraising. It's currently working on the iron sword. To check out what that is. Skills do improve with use, so if we keep collecting items, our appraisal will rise and make it faster to, well, identify other things. But yeah, the goal with this game is to get as low as possible. We have our mini-map in the corner to help us.
Also, an idea. I feel like they should do some of these games in the future. Like, if they have a random generation, whenever there's a room that's just one square in size, just actually make it into the cleaning closet or broom closet or something like that.
That's a troll. Yeah, it's a troll. That can stay locked in there. That's a troll.
Here, you're so frightful of a troll.
Yeah, because in this game they are actually quite strong, and well, those are obviously traps as well. Not that the troll is setting them off, of course.
How many mini-games with trolls can be slightly easily, but usually more very tough enemies, so they are usually not a joke.
Yeah, okay, some more stuff. Pickaxe. I believe with pickaxes we would be able to break through walls if we wanted to.
Okay, that sounds handy.
Okay, where'd that skeleton go? Ooh, a staff. There we go.
Yeah, as I can see in this game, the spear being very good. Since, yeah, you get some distance.
And apparently that was a fountain of fruit juice.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Like I did say, it's random and can be entirely random. Oh, a gem?
Yeah, I did not expect to be that random.
The staff. Our inventory is filling up, but we can at least sell all of these things if we find a merchant. Let's check over here. The minimap says we haven't gone this way yet. Porto staff. Some more gold. I keep hearing something skittering around.
Yeah. I can't get him ready to tell you to turn around.
Yeah. I don't think a torch will do much good for defense.
Well, you can hit someone with it.
Yeah. Giant what? Spider. Spiders. Let's not.
Fresh. Wait. Hold on. Hold on. You found fresh meat.
Yep.
And fresh that's the torch cream. Gun. Fresh cream pie?
Yep.
Wait. I mean, someone recently made it and lost them here.
Yeah, when I very much doubt we're the first one to go down here.
Yeah. The fresh meat would be question is it animal meat or human meat?
Yeah, probably best not to question too much. It's, yeah, the way we've seen it before, but the way you get down to the next level is by finding a hatch in the floor, which of course is found somewhere randomly. Okay, we leveled up. Let's just steal their gear. Our inventory is really filling up. There it is. That's how we get down to the next level, but it's a one-way trip. Oop. And that can also happen. So let's finish up exploring this level. Things will, of course, get more difficult the lower down you go. Let's see, do we actually need separate arrows for this? No, we don't. Okay, that is good to know. That way we can weaken some enemies before they get close to us.
Wait, I just realized you do wield a spear and are two. More games should allow one-handed spears with shields and such. I kind of get a bit annoyed that there are not many games that does that.
Oh, hello. A book, some more weapons. Okay, I think we are getting slowed down by the amount of stuff that we're carrying around, and we are almost dead.
Yeah, you're almost dead indeed.
And let's see. Okay, we're carrying that much around. Let's see, we have 5 armor. Armor will of course get damaged over time as well. Let's see.
How many cream pies have you picked up?
I think the game might be stuck or something. Let's just throw it out for a second. Or, okay, I think the character might be trying to appraise it, but be unable to tell if it's good or bad.
Improved!
It does help with that, at least. Oh. Fresh minus 1 cream pie. It's a cursed pie. So yeah, chucking that.
Hey, don't explain why there was a fresh cream pie in the dungeon. One of the skeletons made it.
What is that
wait,
symbol?
Hold on, let's think about it.
Oh crap, the Minotaur is coming.
Okay, maybe it was the Minotaur that made it.
Yeah, there's the hatch. What's this here? No trespassing. know, of course, that's a level. Yeah, that's flashing next to our health. Yeah, that means that the Minotaurs are going to come after us if we hang around here too long. So let's just grab what we can. Nope. Our inventory is full. You almost snuck up on me. Let's throw one of these torches out and pick that up. Hopefully get it identified.
Hello. Anyone here?
Glasses. A gem that we don't have room for. I don't want to throw out a torch because I don't know how often those will come later. Let's just get out. Oh, the caves are filled with unnatural darkness, and yeah, this would be a good reason why to carry around a torch at all times. Okay. And somewhere a trap got set off. Oh, hello, you have got some funny bones. Okay.
Funny bones? Don't you mean it has a terrifying red axe?
I'm guessing that's a random enemy, or a random boss-like enemy that can spawn. And, yeah. That's one way in which you can get just completely screwed over. By randomization, and this is it now identified all of the stuff that we were carrying with us. Most of this is normal, a cursed sword, a cursed staff. I don't remember exactly what curses do. This one it just doesn't give any armor. And these probably have a weaker attack than an uncursed, yep. Okay, so they are still usable. I just hope that whenever something is cursed, it isn't unremovable. But yeah.
Still, cursed cream pie.
Yeah.
The skeletons definitely must have made it in hope to some adventurer eats it.
Okay, shall we leave it with this one there, or shall we give the next game whatever time we have left, about 15 minutes? Actually, yeah, we started late, so we have about, 17 minutes left.
I guess, how do we basically break a record here?
In that let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that would make 6 games that we've covered, and I don't remember covering 6 games in one go.
Never have. It has usually been between 4 or less.
Yeah, or 5. So, let's start up the next game on the list.
Yeah, really 5. The only time you could say 5 is when one of the games did not work.
Yeah. Oh, why is that FPS counter showing in the upper left?
It has been doing that for a while.
Okay, maybe that's something in Steam that I changed. Let's see. Settings. In-game. Overlay, yes. FPS counter. Off. Okay, there we go. I only just now noticed that. That might have been going on for a hell of a long time. But this is Barotrauma. This game might be known to some, but others... let's jump into the training. In this game, you have 5 classes here. We have the mechanic, we have the engineer, we have the medical doctor, the security officer, and the captain. There is a 6th career, so to speak, but they're a jack of all trades. So let's start with the mechanic.
Oh dear. And also, Hillyan, I think you've been having that FPS counter over a year?
Okay. Oh, it's finally gone then. And yeah, this is a 2D game. WSD, yes. Are you okay? We need to get up and moving. Get to the sub ASAP. Okay. Open the door, which we do by clicking the button. We're clicking the door, depending on if the door will accept direct commands. Interact with containers by left... Boo. By pressing left mouse, transfer items between the containers and your inventory by dragging or double-clicking. Equip items by double-clicking them or by pressing the corresponding quick slot key. Okay, and they added in videos of that. Okay, got a diving mask, a welding tool, and a wrench. Hey, remember to get your gear from the locker. Grab everything you can carry. We're in for some rough shit. Hey, I'm reading some hull breaches along your way. Better plug those real quick to buy us some time. Yeah, hull breaches in this game are bad because, well, we're all of this is underwater.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Equip your welding tool and diving mask by double clicking on them. Use the welding tool to repair leaks in hulls. The diving mask will provide you with oxygen while on the water. When a welding tool is equipped, hold the right mouse button to aim while aiming left to weld. And yeah, that is completely flooded, so let's put that on. Equip the welder. And here we go. And yeah, there are water physics in this game, so you can get pushed around by water. Okay, here we go, just fix that up. There we go. Turn the nearby pump on by interacting and hitting the beta red button to turn it on. There we go. And pumps, of course, well, pump out water. Or air, if you turn it around.
That sounds like a bad idea.
Yeah. All right, can you hear me? I've got bad news and good news. The bad news is there's a fire ahead. The good news is that there's probably enough scrap nearby for you to make a fire extinguisher. Okay, so we just go down. Deconstructor. The fabricator is a device that can take different kinds of materials and turn them into useful items. Materials can be found, bought, or obtained from breaking down other items with a deconstructor. To create a fire extinguisher, you need aluminum. Ugh. And sodium. Sodium is readily available, but that must be deconstructed from oxygen tanks. Okay, here we got some tanks and some sodium. We just chuck those in there and deconstruct them, which will take a bit of time. And there we go. It does produce them. It does work them only one at a time, though. But they will work even when you step away. So, fire extinguisher, held carbon dioxide extinguisher, and create. Items like this do require skill levels, but those are generally gained by just using abilities. So yeah, now we have the extinguisher, and same as the weapon. There we go. Some items are too large to carry around in your inventory. To unequip the fire extinguisher, drag it away from the inventory and release the mouse button. Yep, there we go, just drop it on the floor.
Oh dear.
You're almost there, just be careful. This next leak is large enough for the whole room to be pressurized. Find a diving suit or the pressure will kill you. Yeah, you will just get squished like a grape if you're uncareful. Yep, here's the suit.
Squished like a grape? Really?
Yep. A diving suit protects the wearer from high pressure. Equip one to be able to swim outside the submarine and in other high pressure environments. Check the oxygen indicator under the diving suit icon to see how much oxygen you have left in your suit's tank, and remember to replace the oxygen tank when it's empty. And when
always,
you... Yep.
Always open.
Always open what? Or how? Oh, that.
Over.
Oh. Yeah. Again, water physics can shove you around quite a bit. That must have been looted from some sort of shop.
Yeah, they just decided to put it somewhere concerning.
Let's Let's see, we can't open that. Pump is screwed, it looks like. Oh, we need to fix this. Okay. There we go. Mechanical repairs. Devices require maintenance or they'll stop working. Mechanical devices take a wrench to repair. Equip a wrench and interact E with a device to repair it. Items needed maintenance are marked with a repair icon. For this case, there we go. If we press the button again whilst the bar is in a colored area, it'll speed up a bit. But you can hurt yourself whilst repairing stuff if you are not skilled enough. There we go. And then we just go down the ladder. There we go. Submarine maintenance. Find the engine, usually located in the rear compartment of a submarine, and ballast pumps at the bottom. Note that some submarines have multiple ballast tanks. Welcome aboard. First thing you need to do is check the engine and ballast pumps, see if they're in need of maintenance. And if I remember correctly, a captain can put those markers down for where stuff is needed. Okay, let's get to work again. That's the timer of the Barony going off. I forgot to stop it. There we go. We got our skill upgraded some.
You forgot to turn up Barony?
No, the timer for Barony.
Oh, okay. Got a bit concerned.
Okay, now the engine. This requires 55 in mechanical skill. Oh yeah. Stuff like this will break down constantly, so an engineer will have to, or rather, it's mechanical, mechanic and electrical engineer. The electrical engineer we'll get to in a bit. I keep confusing what some of, what they do at times. But yeah, and my headset is complaining to me to charge it. Okay. Well done. Let's wait for the others to make their way here. Can't very well operate the sub with just the two of us, or something like that. Okay. Engineer training, who deals with the electrics. Okay. So, yeah, let's give this a bit more, or at least until my headset gives out. Let's see. Get your ass up. We need power. Okay. Same as before. The last impact cut power to half of the outpost. I want you to grab what you need to get us online again. Okay. Fuel rod, screwdriver, and wires. The electrical engineer's job can get quite complicated. Some more fuel rods. And there we go. Reactor fuel. Submarines and outposts are powered by nuclear reactors, which consume fuel. Place a fuel rod in the item slot on the left side of the reactor interface. Multiple fuel rods create more heat, but in normal circumstances, one is enough, and any more might cause the reactor to overheat. And yeah, we all know what happens when a nuclear reactor overheats.
Dear.
Set the fission rate so that the needle is on green, then do the same for turbine output. Try to keep the output as close to load as possible to avoid power outages or overheating. The power grid load fluctuates, so keep an eye on the reactor load and output and react to any changes. Okay, so we just move this up. There we go, that's in green. Then we move this. There we go. And of course you can turn the entire damn thing off if you want to, but you'd rather not want to. Okay, this needs to be moved up more because there's more power being drawn. Okay. Let's just leave that as is. Oh, come on. Of Critically low temperature, what? Yeah, this is why I don't play engineer on this. Okay, is it satisfied now? Still... The hell is go... Let's up this more then. There we... There we go. Yeah, this is an annoying balancing act. There we go. We seem to be stable now. Some junction boxes blew their fuses and pumps aren't working. You should go see what you can do about it. Remember to switch the reactor in to automatic before you go. Oh. Automatic control there. I don't know exactly what that does, but I presume it at least tries to not blow itself up.
Oh dear.
But I have heard that there is a sneaky little thing that you can do with some parts to have a nuclear reactor basically automate itself to constantly be running at almost peak efficiency. But I don't know the exact way to do that. But I know I could probably find a video about that. Let's see. Like the mechanical items, junction boxes need maintenance. In addition to wear and tear, they are damaged by water and overvoltage. Electrical devices are repaired with a screwdriver. Equip one and interact. Yep, there we go. Yeah, electrical systems are a lot more likely to damage you because, well, you can get zapped. Some of the wiring seems to be faulty. Find some wire and do a quick fix, otherwise we're without power. Junction boxes connected submarine's devices to the power grid through wires. Equip a screwdriver and wire, then interact with the item you want to add to the power grid. Direct the wire to the power pin, then press right mouse button to close the panel. Repeat the step at the next device. Okay, just grab that. Put that there. And then we drag it all the way over. Nope. To here.
Oh dear.
And there we go. Now it's connected somewhat.
I keep expecting you to blow yourself up at the moment.
Yeah, that reactor could probably blow at any moment. But yeah, wire and electrical components are always nice to have a few of. Okay, we also need to wire these up. There we go. And that's got the pump working again. Change of plan, come to the sub, we're gonna blow this joint.
Wait, what?
Some extra materials. Yeah, something obviously happened to whatever the hell we are. So we're GTFOing. Okay. Looks like the electrical room's been seeing better days. See if you can get it online, then power up the reactor. Find the sub's electrical room and repair the junction boxes by interacting with them. And it's below us. That's the weapons room. Here we go. Okay. Simple. I don't actually know if it helps too much to be doing this. But I'd like to think... Yeah, it does... It seems to give it a little boost. And yeah, you could probably screw around with these wires quite a bit. And it's probably also the easiest way to sabotage a sub, because with multiplayer in this game, you can turn on traitors, which basically, it speaks for itself, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
It makes it... the role of some people online, or it might make some of them traitors, and their job is to screw over the rest of the crew. Let's see. Nuclear reactors provide power. We've seen that. Drag a fuel rod. Yep. And we've all seen all of that. Okay. Let's see. That's a ballast tank. Is there a door we missed here? And again, the junction boxes and the reactor are typically close to each other. Let's not rewire it. Okay. Throw the temperature up, not too much. Come on. Stay still. And that's the engineer tutorial done. Good work. We make it out of this alive. And next up, the doctor. All of the classes are critical to admission. And the doctor is in charge of keeping everyone alive.
Are you supposed to end stream now?
Let's end it after this tutorial.
All right.
Items instructed. Already seen that. That was a big one. Are you okay? Get yourself patched up fast. We need a medic here, stats. Yep. 2 days since last malpractice lawsuit, really?
Okay. Here.
Morphine and saline. Then we press H to check our medical stats. Afflictions affecting you are shown on the in the list on the right. Some afflictions are local to specific limbs. Inspect different limbs by clicking on them. To treat an affliction, drop the medical item you want to use on the affected limb. You have some light internal damage, use morphine to treat your internal damage now. I'll just say this outright. Morphine for this is overkill. And yeah, that's basically our health bar up here. If it goes all the way to red, you start dying, or you just outright dead. Or you can be resuscitated. Okay. They've got a nasty burn. You don't have any bandages with you, do you? Yeah, get them to follow you while you find some. Okay, crew commands. Get the patient to follow you to the med bay. Press middle mouse to open the command wheel. Click on movement, follow, and select the character you want to issue the command to. Okay, and this is Darren Hebert. Okay, movement, follow, Darren. So get along, you. And here we have some bandages and some extra stuff. Treat burns. Treat others by highlighting the target and pressing H. Double-click an item in the medical interface to administer it to a patient. Bandages heal burns quickly. Find them in the highlighted cabinets. Yeah, grab them. We get their stats. They have a burn. So we select that. If you select an affliction itself, it will also give you examples down here. You could also use it from your own inventory. For now, just apply it through here. Though those aren't always the best treatments. But it makes it a lot easier. Okay. Guess that I'll do. Make your way to the sub. It's too dangerous to stay here. Let's see, resuscitation. When characters suffer too many injuries, they become unconscious. In this state, their oxygen level falls constantly, and when it gets to zero, they die. They can be resuscitated through CPR. Resuscitate the patient by entering the medical interface and clicking the green resuscitate button. The process may take a while, depending on your medical skill. And, if your skills are too low for this, you're more likely to just smash their ribs. So, yeah, leave that to the bloody doctor, unless absolutely necessary.
Yeah, I can see that turning into a very horrible disaster quickly. Yeah.
Good, everyone's here. Check up on everybody while we get the vessel ready for transit. Inspect every patient by pressing H and administer the correct treatment. Remember to check each limb by selecting them in the medical interface. Medical supplies are often found in medbay or storage, along with basic meds in supply cabinets scattered throughout the sub, which are these little things here. We've passed a few of them. Equip the health scanner helmet to see who is injured and how. This thing here is really freaking useful because it will just highlight injuries on characters. Like Tanya here, they have 36% internal damage, so we're grabbing you. Okay, you are getting morphine for that. That's one hell of a headache. Okay, let's just double check. Some bandages, saline. This is very useful.
I should also say that this happened on a submarine on an alien planet.
Yep. Oh, someone needs medical assistance.
Nope. And we are, of course, not alone in water.
Didn't we just... Did you just fall down here and immediately... Okay. Bandage up your head. And you got burned in the face. Yeah, we're bandaging that especially. As you can see, it lowers the amount, but it doesn't lower it instantly. Some things will take longer to be treated than others. And yeah, that may seem simple, but the job of a medical doctor in Barotrauma is basically... you're basically playing the survival part of a survival horror in this game. Because you need to ensure that everyone is staying alive and that you aren't wasting your resources on minor injuries.
Yeah, it's... I don't know... Maybe... the hardest one?
Yeah, depending on how well everything else is going, because your resources are dependent on how well the jobs go, and that is dependent on how well everyone is doing their job. And even though each of these specializes in their areas, you can still do what other classes do, except for, well, specific things with points and crafting and such. But a mechanic can still work on the electronics, a doctor can still repair the mechanics, but they will just be far less better at it than the specialized ones. And yeah, security officer and captain, I think those mostly speak for themselves what those would be doing.
Yeah, it kind of does.
So let's end that. Yeah, that's a record 6 games in one Sunday. So let's move over to here. And yeah, this was the 68th episode of our Showcase Sunday. We've been going with for a hell of a long time, huh?
Yeah, and I'm suddenly concerned for next Sunday.
Yeah, that was the browser. I still don't know why the hell OBS and Discord are in such disagreement with that. But yeah. There is a new update for OBS. I will install it after this because I'm no longer going to just update OBS before streams because, well, we already know how that went a few times.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see who's online. Touch Scaly Tail is online streaming Deep Rock Galactic. Shrimp OS is online just chatting at the moment, it seems. Oh yeah, they're doing a subathon, which basically they put up a stream and stream whenever they can, but it stays up even when they are asleep. And well, for everyone that subs to them, it gets extended by a certain amount of time.
Yeah, I don't get it. It doesn't sound like a healthy thing.
Yeah. Then we have Wolf Machina, who is streaming The Sims 4. I have heard rumors that people are expecting The Sims 5 to be announced soon.
Wait, there is no... At this point, I thought there was at least up to Sims 8 or something.
No, that's because they keep releasing contact patches and expansion packs. Though, from most of what I heard, the core of Sims 4 is good with some of its things, but... Compared to other things, it's a massive downgrade from Sims 3.
Oh.
Yeah, the best thing I know about Sims 4 is two of its mechanics, one of which is the mood system, which, well, can have Sims' mood be changed depending on interactions, and the fact that they can actually multitask things, so they can actually eat and talk at the same time. But beyond that... it is a downgrade from Sims 3 because Sims 3 just has so much more freaking big areas and actual cities that you can move around through, whilst in Sims 4 it's back to just a single household that you can actively, well, act on.
Okay. And I only liked Sims a short bit when I was younger, but I quickly grew bored of it.
Yeah, it's not for everyone. And, well, Sims 4 is also... I believe still to this day is buggy as all hell. But moving on. Next up we have QuickMind, who is streaming XCOM UFO Defense. Azra Fox is a 12-hour anniversary stream, but they are just chatting at the moment, so they might just be on break. Then we have Grimmith streaming Sid Meier's Alpha Centauri, okay, which is basically a civilization in space. That's Conrad Zimmerman streaming Spelunky 2. And Iggy Maid is streaming Instruments of Destruction. Can't say I've heard of that before.
Maybe have heard of it. Maybe, not sure.
Yeah. Any of those sound interesting?
Instruments of Destruction, maybe?
Okay, let me take a quick look at them. Oh, and my headset just ran out of power, so I won't be able to hear whatever you're saying. Okay, it looks a bit like that Besiege game, but more interactive. Let's give them a raid. Copy the name. And yeah, go to our place. /raid. Paste, but not start yet. Okay. I'm going through this dev. So thank you everyone who deaf and unable to speak apparently. Thank you everyone who has been watching now or later. I still need to change the backdrop of this scene to the new artwork, but oh well. thank you all for watching, and thank you. Glacier Boy 7x7. Thank you for watching, and as always, thank you as well, Drakir.
You're welcome as always, my friend.
And I can see by your icon lighting up that you are actually replying. You know, you could be saying just about anything, making fun of me, for all I know. We will be streaming again later today in the evening, about 8 p.m., which would be in about 2 hours and 45 minutes from now, if nothing gets in the way, that is. And yeah, if we can, we'll be starting on the next Shantae game, Shantae Half Genie Hero. For now, let's start that raid. And yeah, anyone else who has been watching, thank you as well, all the same. And until next time, have a nice day, and until then.
Be safe, everyone, and remember, Hillyan is the beardless captain.
Laters.
Laters.